Hey guys, thanks for watching this walkthrough of Arkham Knight Glitchless. So the main reason for doing this walkthrough is because I think this is a great category, especially for beginners to start out with, but there's a lot of tribal knowledge in it that isn't really documented anywhere, so I wanted to put together this video series in order to document this tribal knowledge and sort of step through the game and how to speedrun the glitchless category. So first we have this opening cutscene where we burn the Joker body. So the rules for this category and all Arkham Knight categories is to start the timer when we start burning the body. And so we see this zoom out here. We can start burning the body as soon as the zoom is over, which is what we will do momentarily. Comes in the night and repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool? So the camera stops, so now we can burn the body, start the timer. Use your mentality. I don't have a timer, but if you had a timer, you would start it now. So once you start burning the body, you have this title card. You can't skip any of this.
Is how
you have to
happened.
Wait till Gordon says this is how the Batman died. It'll
the
fade
Batman
out
died.
And then after this you can skip to cutscenes just spamming the right click. Then we get to this diner scene. There's nothing you can skip here. Just
thanks.
Look around, look at all the
no
Easter
problem.
Eggs. Like here we see Henry Adams.
Oh, thanks,
got this
honey.
Nice waitress. There's gonna be
so? What'll it be? Your usual?
Things sure. about different people disappearing because they're
no
kidnapped basically by
no, you know what?
Batman.
Waffles.
You can look at the menu, you can look at the candles.
Don't tell my wife.
You can see this
whatever
guy dressed in a
opposite.
Batman mask, this guy dressed in another mask
oh,
who
if you want some more coffee,
scares him. It's a lot of Easter eggs in this scene. It's pretty cool, especially like if you keep running this game a lot, you'll notice all of these things.
Hey, I'm sorry to interrupt your dinner, officer, Owens, but there's a guy smoking over there in the corner booth. Wait here. I'll have a word.
So now we can walk over to this guy. I like to, so as usual, just take like a straight path there. So, and I spam the space bar when I'm heading over there so that I can interact immediately. If you're using controller, then you spam whatever button that is. So in general, I use keyboard for everything except pulling out canisters. For those, I use controller because it's a little bit easier for me. You can use controller for almost anything. I think gliding, it's easier to use keyboard and mouse. Fighting, I like to use keyboard and mouse. So this guy, you have to... It's faster to shoot the guy, so I just shoot him. Walk forward. I also have to usually move a little bit to the right so that you trigger this guy attacking you a little bit earlier. So after this, the TV, you zoom out of this TV news thing. You can skip this eventually. Then we have this unskippable cutscene, which kind of introduces
the only people left on the streets are
how
the sort that
all the criminals
the
are. On the street, how
Gotham's
everybody's rioting, how basically Gotham is deserted now except for these criminals, and that the only one who can save everyone is Batman. So you just watch this cutscene.
Not enough good people left to stop. It took just 24 hours for us to lose control of the city. Tonight, Gotham's relying on one man to save us all.
So the next thing I'm going to go over is sort of the different kinds of movement you can have while gliding. So the optimal way to glide in general is you do a dive bomb for 3.5 seconds, so, and then pull up, and then this is kind of the maximum speed that you're going to have. So again, you 1, 2, 3.5, and then you'll be able to, if you go straight up, you'll gain height. So notice that here we're around this statue up here. So 1, 2, 3.5. And if we pull up, you'll notice that we actually go above the statue now. So if you keep doing that, dive bombing for 3.5 seconds and pulling up, then you'll actually gain height, and that's kind of the maximum amount of speed you get. Likewise, if you're familiar with any of the Arkham games, like Arkham City, you have this grapnel boost. So what basically, when thinking about movement, the actual grapple and boosting is pretty fast. It's faster than gliding usually. But the resulting glide that you have afterward is pretty slow. So like, if you compare it with like when you do the dive bomb, you see that on the side of Batman's cape there's like these lines, which indicates that Batman's going through the air very quickly. But when you do a grapple boost, there's no lines, and you basically have no speed, especially if you haven't upgraded your grapple boost. And in the glitches category, you don't upgrade that at all. So the alternative way of getting speed is doing something called grapple canceling. So you grapple and then cancel it before you actually get to the top. So instead of boosting, you just cancel it. And then you can see that you have the lines on the side of his cape, which means that you're going pretty fast. So the button to cancel the grapple on keyboard is the middle mouse wheel. You just click it and then it'll cancel it. There's another way to cancel grapples. Let's see if I can find something here. Basically, you can do grapple swings as well. Let's just find a place where we can do a grapple swing. So you can cancel grapples in the. So you see here, I did a grapple boost and there's no speed. But you can do grapple cancels with the middle mouse wheel if you're grappling upwards or to the side. Then you can also do grapple swings, which is like, this is a grapple swing. And you can cancel grapple swings with the left control. So that's sort of how you do it. And you can gain, if you do it at kind of while Batman is swinging upward, you actually get a lot of speed that way. So this is basically the standard movement for gliding in this game, and it takes a bit. It's not that difficult, but it's if you're not used to it, it's a little bit tricky. So it's not tricky, but it's a little bit different from what you're used to when you normally play the game. So when we start playing this, we want to get to GCPD. So this is the place where we start. So the way that I get there is I go here, I dive for 3.5 seconds, pull up, then grapple this guy here, then cancel it. And then I grapple to Gordon at kind of the first opportunity, so. So you skip that cutscene, you skip this dialogue. So now we need to go rescue a GCPD officer. So what I do is I dive, then grapple, cancel again, and then you can go over these buildings here to get to this marker. So now we get to our first piece of combat. What I'm playing, so right now if we look at the game options, I'm playing on hard right now. So I think it's a good time to go over kind of the difference between the difficulties. Hard and, so easy is, there's easy, there's normal, and there's hard. So easy, normal, hard. Basically the main difference between easy and hard are that the combat Basically, in combat, enemies attack faster on hard. You take a lot more damage in combat. When you get shot, you can basically get shot three times with a regular gun. You can get shot. You can get killed immediately with a shotgun on hard, and likewise with a sniper rifle, you'll get killed immediately. Easy, you can take many, many gunshots. And then the difference between normal, easy, and hard is basically the enemies attack at the same speed as easy on normal, but you take more damage. And then in Predators, basically on easy, you're designed to be invincible in Predators without any armor upgrades, whereas in normal, you're designed to be invincible with armor upgrades. So in practice, because you don't get armor upgrades in Glitchless, you're going to basically do Predators in a very similar way to the way that you would do it in hard. So we'll get to that when we get to our first Predator. But basically, in general, the strategy is that for combat and for tank battles, easy and normal are basically the same. And then for Predators, hard and normal are basically the same. And otherwise, things are going to be a bit different between the difficulties. So I'm going to do this fight here on hard. It's kind of here we have no upgrades, so really you kind of just need to just punch people. Watch out for guys who start charging at you. And so I just messed up there. What you want to do is, if a guy's charging at you, you want to throw a batarang at him. It'll knock him out immediately. And so I just messed up there. So on hard, you also will want to do combo takedowns a lot of the time. You'll also want to counter. So that's an example of a guy who is charging at you. You throw a batarang at him. So the difference mainly in combat between easy and hard is that on easy, so I'm gonna just do the same fight, but I'm gonna do it on easy. So on hard, you'll want to usually counter a lot when you can, because the enemies attack pretty quickly, and if you don't counter, it takes a while to build up a combo so you can do things. But if on easy, they attack much more slowly, so you can actually avoid countering a lot, and you pretty much never want to do combo takedowns on easy. So yeah, throw a batarang at that guy. So you kind of don't need to counter at all on easy. You can also oftentimes just not hold a direction while you're punching, and then you will automatically hit people who are about to attack you. So that's kind of the difference between easy and hard combat. So hard, you'll have to be a bit more careful. You'll need to counter more, use combo takedowns, maybe even beat down sometimes. Easy, you don't have to do any of that. You just punch, don't hold a direction most of the time, and you don't even need to counter a lot of the time. So, but definitely also be sure to make sure you throw batarangs at people who are charging at you. Okay, so I'm going to change the difficulty back to hard just because I like it that way. So now we rescue this officer.
You're safe.
You can skip this cutscene. You can then call the Batmobile, skip that cutscene. So now we're going to chase this truck. This is kind of the easy, the most consistent way of doing this. So you need to go fairly fast, and you want to make sure that that truck shoots an RPG at that intersection we just passed. Then we see this animation where he blows up the police car. So now what we want to do is circle around this here, basically we're cutting off the truck. Stay on the left side of the road, and you'll have a much easier time hitting that truck. So that's kind of the easiest, most consistent way of getting to this, of doing this evening the odds mission. So now we interrogate the soldier. He's going to tell you basically to go visit Oracle at some point.
Where's Scarecrow?
Go to hell!
So, one thing that that's you want to think about when doing this category or any Arkham category is that you want to be able to skip the dialogue by clicking the mouse button.
Okay.
And that's nice, but then if you click too much, then you'll do this extra punch at the end, which is usually not necessary. So for example here, he's gonna talk to Oracle in just a bit. We're gonna want to skip through that dialogue, but we don't want to do that extra punch at the end. So what I like to do in order to do that is the first thing I want to do after is grapple. So what I'm doing is alternately pressing skip and grapple. So basically, instead of doing that punch at the end, he grappled. And that's just a way of saving a little bit of time. So I messed up the grapple there by grappling to the wrong place, but that's kind of the idea. So now we go to follow the objective marker to this Safehouse. So then you take this guy down, you fight these guys, build up your combo.
You should really review your security.
Then do a combo takedown.
I've seen trees with faster reflexes.
I messed up there again. I do that quite frequently. It's kind of annoying. So, yeah, that was an okay fight, but it would have been nicer if I had done the batarang takedown. So we can skip the new next two cutscenes, then we call in our Batmobile here. So we have to wait a little bit for these to do our first tank battle. So what I like to do is I like to shoot these shields. There are a couple of reasons for that. One is they give you a little bit of XP, which not really that very much to make that much of a difference, but it does give you some, and you have free time to do it. And it's also what you do in 100%, which is a category I also like to do. So now we do our tank battle. So the best way of doing tank battles, particularly when you don't really have a reload speed upgrade, is to alternate between firing and then using the Vulcan gun. So here so you can use the Vulcan gun, and then if you use the Vulcan gun and shoot the glowing part right there, you'll be able to take out these tanks very easily. It's very precise. The best way of actually doing that is to tap the Vulcan gun so that you, because if you hold it too long, then the Vulcan gun becomes very inaccurate. So now we have to deliver Ivy to GCPD, but before we can do that, we have to go do this diagnostic test. So we do it, but we can just abort it immediately. That's just how the game works. When you play it casually, you would do that and get some upgrade points, but it's slow to do that. So
I'm heading there now.
So now, in the previous tank fight, I made sure to charge up my weapons generator. And so then what we do is when we go to this tank battle, we immediately use it. Then what we do is we fight these tanks and don't use the weapons generator again, because we're going to use it later. It takes a while to build up, and we're just going to use it later. So so we do this tank battle. Likewise, you saw that I alternated between shooting the regular gun and shooting the Vulcan gun while the regular gun was reloading.
I need the isolation chamber prepped.
So now we go to GCPD. If you don't know where GCPD is, you can just follow the marker when it shows up. You'll eventually just know where these things are.
Good to have you here, Batman. Bring her down to the lockup.
So now we just go to GCPD and lock up Ivy.
What the hell?
So
fire. It's Batman.
Skip this scene.
What is that thing?
It's this scene.
You kidding me?
This scene, and then when Gordon says civil unrest, we skip that, and then we gain control of Batman. So now what we do is we go and get the remote electric charge gun. So to do that, you can dive, you can run, you can dive about here, at about where you see the Scarface and Bane thing, and then you'll break the glass. So then collect it. You don't specifically need it anytime soon, but in any percent you get it here, and you will need it at some point in the future. So it's to just kind of make things consistent, I just get it now. It's possible that it might be faster to just get it at some point later, but I get it now. So likewise here, you can just dive into this cutscene here. And so then this will be where Cash and Gordon show you the most wanted missions that we're gonna have that we're gonna not do in Glitchless. But if you wanted to play this casually, then you would do them or do 100% or any of the Nightfall categories.
First up, we've lost contact with the fire crew from Station 17. We've got their last known coordinates, but they're not going to survive out
there. So after we do this, we have to select a mission.
Then there's
Select the firefighter mission just because I use keyboard and mouse, and the firefighter mission is pretty much the closest to where the mouse position is when I am clicking through. That's the only reason. It doesn't really matter what mission you click.
Look, I know you're busy, but anything you can do to help is going to save lives.
Spam the mission select button.
I have someone working a lead on Scarecrow. I'll see what I can do.
So then I have to click OK, and then, yeah, so the firefighter mission is here. My mouse was here, so I click the firefighter mission.
I'll find that missing
So when you're here, I made sure to position my camera so that I can then hold back and do a dive roll, and then open the door immediately. So that's just a micro movement there. When you run, then typically, yeah, run diagonally so that you, like if it's a triangle, run diagonally so that you kind of minimize the distance. One very common movement when you exit GCPD is to grapple here and then cancel it to get to the Batmobile. That's faster than running. So now with regards to movement, so right now we can't eject from the Batmobile, but even then, so we have this afterburner now, and typically what happens is that with regards to movement, driving in the Batmobile is faster than gliding, and gliding is faster than running. So when you're moving around, just keep that in mind. Generally, you'll try to use the Batmobile as much as possible. Unless, like, there's good reasons not to. So now we need to get to the Clock Tower. The Clock Tower is a very important place. If you don't know where the Clock Tower is, then instead of selecting the firefighter mission, select the Clock Tower mission, and then it'll tell you where it is. So now let's eject. I like to grapple boost. It's a little bit faster to get up there. You glide. It's usually faster than running. Now we enter the Clock Tower. If you don't know where to enter, use detective vision and it'll kind of show you. You'll eventually get used to it. So you have to be in detective vision to interact with this, so remember to do that.
Identity confirmed.
Then I spam interact with this. You can skip the scene, spam grapple. So now we're gonna see some movement from getting from the Clock Tower to Vanessa. So we do this movement a few times. So that was interesting. So what it is when you're talking with Gordon at this point, when you finish talking to him, Batman's gonna close his wrist communicator thing and then move his arm down, and that's a little bit slow, and so I actually think it's fine to punch through that. I don't know if it's actually faster, it might be a tiny bit slower, but since you're just mashing the mouse button anyway to skip it, it's fine to just punch through that dialogue. So now the movement to get to Vanessa, so Vanessa's right there where the objective marker is, is you run off here, then dive for 3 seconds, 3.5 seconds, then do a grapple onto the left side of that, turn the camera, and then cancel it. So it's a bit tricky. It'll require some practice to do. Ideally, you have enough speed to then grapple to this guy here, and then you dive. Hopefully, you don't actually do that cape floating thing down, but I did. It's not a big deal. So that's the optimal movement. There are other ways you can move there. I don't know if it's the optimal movement, but that's a very nice way to move to from the clock tower to Panessa. And we'll do that same movement again in the future. If a new movement gets discovered for how to do that, then that will be the movement. But this is a pretty good movement as well. It's a little bit tricky. It'll require some practice, especially when you do that grapple cancel off that tower. But it's not that bad. So now we're going to attach this device to power this antenna. There's this animation here. It's just, there are a lot of animations in this game. It's kind of why, one thing I like about it is that there's a lot of opportunities for breaks. The generator so damaged. Now when we power the antenna fails directly. To do this, we have to go get to the Batmobile. There are a couple ways to get there. So the easiest way is to grapple here, do a boost, dive a little bit, and then do a boost off of here. That's how I used to do it, and then you call the Batmobile here. But then so that's one way of doing that. A more advanced way of doing it is to see if this. Okay, so a more advanced way of doing this is to zoom in, grapple the corner of this, then cancel it, and you see that you have a very fast glide. Then you call the Batmobile here. So that's the faster way of doing it, but it's pretty difficult. It requires a bit of practice. If you're starting out, you can do the first set of movement. So now we pull this Berber Rail station sign down. So getting onto this, I like to back up, do a couple of afterburners, then you pull this thing. You don't need to pull it all the way up, you can pull it about to right here, and then use that to launch. Then you can be as careful as you want here. It's so long as you don't fall. Like, for example, you can accelerate through that, but make sure you don't fall off because that'll lose a lot of time. Likewise, you can go around here like this. Slightly faster is to just accelerate through here. It's a little scary because you bounce and it's hard to control, but it is a little faster. So then you grapple, or not grapple, but you winch onto here. Go up this Johnny Charisma sign, up to Panessa. I spam the Vulcan gun so that I eventually let go. Then you go here, you power this. So you skip this. So again, now when we do this, the movement is... There are a couple ways to move it. So the easiest movement is to grapple boost here, then do a dive bomb for 3.5 or so seconds, then grapple onto this and cancel it, and then fly on over to the marker. So I'm gonna then show the more advanced movement. It's a bit harder, but it's faster. So, oops. So yeah. So you see that? So what would happen is we would be. to go around this way. So if you remember, we're going to be behind the Batmobile here, at about here. So then what you can do is zoom in again, and again, grapple to this far corner of this building, and then cancel it. And then you actually have enough speed to get to the marker. So when you get here, the easiest way to do this is to just land over here, and that triggers the dialogue immediately. There's another way to actually kind of skip some of these dialogues, but it's a bit weird and I don't quite understand it, so maybe for the next walkthrough.
If I alert them, they'll kill the hostage.
Grapple here.
If I can separate them, they'll be easier to take down.
Battering. So then this is basically our, technically our first predator. You kind of do the same thing though. You silent take down this guy. Then what I like to do is I like to batarang this guy and then do a ground takedown. You can silent take down him as well. I don't know if it's actually faster, but that's sort of what I like to do. So now we get our new bat suit. And so, basically, I messed up there, but what you can do is you can hold forward and run, like, immediately after the, you get to that black fade-out. So now we're gonna skip through this, suit introduction. So a little micro-movement is to run forward a little bit, then grapple and then cancel it. Ideally, you would roll about to about here, close to this grate where you then do the do your first fear takedown. So we do our fear takedown. Then rescue this guard.
He said you were quick, but I never saw anyone take down three-armed guys like that. Unbelievable.
You're safe now. I'll send someone to pick you up.
Thank you. Tell me you're gonna find
Scarecrow. So one thing you'll notice is we got our first upgrade point. So what I like to do is actually at this point, we'll get the critical strikes upgrade. So what that is you're in the upgrade menu, you go to combat, and then you click these two fists here. So usually you'll, ideally you would get the critical strikes upgrade at this point. It is possible for you not to get it, have enough upgrade points to get it right now. Usually that's because in the previous tank battles you got hit. And that happens all the time. If you don't have the critical strikes upgrade, just get it when you can. This is a very important upgrade, especially on hard. So now we hack this antenna. Oracle dialogue. So now our antennas are now what it is he's going to find out that we need to go to Ace.
I need to use both antennas that we just hacked. Radio wave frequencies across Gotham. If I can find both frequencies,
so Ace
same
is
location,
in the is in the, on the right. So manufacturing his toxin. Align these antennas to the right. I think this is the
radio and microwave frequencies point to Ace Chemicals. That's where Scarecrow's producing the toxin.
So now we need to get to Ace, and as I mentioned before, you want to usually you want to primarily use the Batmobile to drive there. But grapple cancels are also very fast, so there's a nice grapple cancel.
Or worse.
So the so if you're starting out, the easiest movement is to go over here, do a grapple boost, and then call the Batmobile into here, and then drive on over to Ace. A more advanced movement is you're here, you grapple to about. You grapple, aim here for the grapple, and then cancel it. You then glide to this gas station across GCPD and call the Batmobile. The nice thing about this gas station is that, like, sometimes if you call the Batmobile on this street, like, here, there's a car that that'll hit you. But if you're in the gas station, like, the car isn't gonna drive into you, like it would if you were on the street. Now you can just kind of follow the arrows to get to base chemicals. And then, it's important when you get to these, this part of the bridge to exit, because there's an animation of Batman exiting the Batmobile.
Any word from inside?
For that.
Nothing.
We think so I'm going to end this first part there, of the walkthrough here. I'll get to the second part in the next video. Thanks.